Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here, welcome back. I've previously covered how to track videos embedded on your website into GA4, Google Analytics 4. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to report on the performance of those videos. We're going to create an exploration report in GA4 to do this. If you're tracking embedded YouTube videos using enhanced measurement or tracking Vimeo or other embedded videos, the next step is to report on their performance. And if you haven't set up video tracking yet, then check out my dedicated tutorials. I've included links in the description below this video. Okay, let's head to Google Analytics to look at reporting. The first thing I recommend doing is checking that embedded videos are actually being tracked into Google Analytics. To do this, let's navigate to Reports. Then Engagement. And let's select Events. This report shows us all of the events that have been collected into Google Analytics. And what we're looking for is the video event. So let's search for video in the report. If you've tracked embedded YouTube videos using enhanced measurement, then you'll see video start, video progress, and video complete events. And in case you're not familiar with enhanced measurement, it's a feature in GA4 that lets you automatically track a number of important actions on your website, including when people watch videos, when they click outbound links, download files, and more. If you would like to learn more about enhanced measurement, I've included links in the description below this video. The video start event is collected when someone clicks to play a video. Video progress events are collected when people have watched 10%, 25, 50, and 75% of the video. And the video complete event is collected when people make it to the end of the embedded video. Apart from the top level information available in this report, you probably want to see more details about the videos people are watching on your website and how much they've watched. To do this, we're going to create an exploration report. So let's navigate to Explore. And let's create a new blank report. Let's name the report Embedded Videos. Now we need to import the dimensions and metrics we want to use in our report. So let's click the plus sign next to Dimensions. And if we scroll to the very bottom, we can see there is a section called Video. Let's select this. And we can see the dimensions we can add to our report. We can add video provider, video title, and video URL. If you're using enhanced measurement to automatically track embedded YouTube videos, then video provider will be set to YouTube. Then if you've implemented additional video tracking, like I've covered in my other tutorials, then you'll be able to compare YouTube to Vimeo or any other video platforms you're tracking. And of course, video title will let you report on the titles of your videos embedded on your website. And video URL will let you report on the URLs of the individual videos. Let's enable all of these dimensions. The other dimension that is automatically collected when people watch embedded videos is the visible dimension. This lets you report if the video was visible in someone's browser. So let's search for visible. And enable this dimension. Since we might also want to report on the pages within our website where people are watching videos, let's also search for and enable page path. You could also enable other page-based dimensions, like page location and page title, but I'm just going to use page path. And let's also search for and enable event name. Now let's click Import. And let's click the plus sign next to Metrics. If we search for Video, we won't find any predefined metrics available in Google Analytics. This means that if you currently want to report on things like video duration, the amount of time people have watched your videos, then you will need to register them as a custom definition in Google Analytics. So we'll look at how we can do this in just a moment. Before we do, let's head back to the exploration report we were just creating. Before we register parameters to use in our report, I want to show you some of the default metrics you can use. Let's search for event. And let's enable event count. We can use this metric in our report since it's a predefined metric. And let's also enable event count per user. Now let's search for users. And let's enable total users. Feel free to also experiment by adding additional event, user, and session-based metrics to your exploration report. But I'm going to stick with these and click Import. Now we can drag any of the dimensions we want to include in our report under rows. So let's add video title. And then let's drag the event count and total users metrics under values. We can now see any embedded videos that have been tracked on our website, along with the total number of video events. We can see there is a row in the report that is blank for video title. This is for all of the other events, so the non-video events that have been collected on the website. So we're going to create a filter to remove this. In the second column, let's scroll to the bottom. And let's click to add a filter. And select video title. Then matches regex. And enter full stop, plus sign, and click apply. This will mean that the report only includes results where the video title dimension includes one or more characters. So this will remove any blank results from our report. We've now created the basis of a report for our embedded videos in Google Analytics, and you can spend time adjusting the dimensions and metrics used in the report, depending on what you want to understand about your videos. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. Okay, let's say we want to see the number of users watching our embedded videos, along with details about if they're starting and completing videos. To do this, let's change the metric to total users. And then let's drag the event name dimension under columns. We can now see the titles of our videos on the left. And then the first three columns in the report tells us the number of users based on video starts, completion, and progress events. And let's look at one more example. Let's say we want to see where people are watching embedded videos on our website. To do this, let's remove the event name dimension and add the page path dimension under rows, but above the video title dimension. And let's also add the event count metrics under values. This means we can now see where people watch videos on our website in the first column and the video they watched in the second column. Now that we've looked at what we can report on using the default metrics and dimensions, I want to show you how to register custom definitions for two things you might want to include in your reports, video percent and video duration. You will need editor or administrator level permission to do this in Google Analytics. Let's take a look. We need to navigate to Configure. And then Custom Definitions. Let's start by creating a custom dimension for video percent. To do this, we click the Create Custom Dimensions button. Name the dimension video percent. Leave event set as the scope. And enter video underscore percent, all lowercase, as the event parameter. Now we click Save. This won't apply to historical data, but moving forward you'll be able to report on the percent, so 10, 25, 50, 75, and 100% progress people make through your videos. Now let's select the Custom Metrics tab, and click the Create Custom Metrics button. Let's enter Video Duration as the name, then enter Video underscore Duration, all lowercase, as the event parameter. And select seconds as the unit of measurement. And click Save. This custom metric will let you report on the total amount of time people have spent watching your embedded videos. Hopefully at some point Google adds these as predefined dimensions and metrics to use in our reports, but currently we need to create them as custom definitions. Now let's navigate back to Explore. Open the report we created previously, and we can add the dimension to our report. and we can also add the metric. If you've just created these custom definitions, then you won't see values reported yet. You will need to wait until data has been collected, since they don't apply to any historical data that's already been processed into Google Analytics. But moving forward, you will be able to use them in your exploration reports. Once you're tracking embedded videos in Google Analytics, you'll be able to use the exploration reports to see insights about the videos people are watching. As we've seen, there are a number of pre-configured metrics and dimensions you can use straight away. Plus, you can also register custom metrics and dimensions to use in your reports too. What dimensions and metrics are you going to use to report on embedded videos? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.